Good morning, all of you. My name is Karthik Kumar. Welcome to Sri Sai Vedanta AD classes. Today's session is for class 8 in the subject IIT Chemistry. Chapter name is GOC, General Organic Chemistry. And today's topic is nomenclature of alkenes. As earlier discussed that ene represents that contain one double bond between the carbon atoms. It is one of the unsaturated hydrocarbon, and now its hybridization is sp2. Each and every carbon in alkene with the hybridization sp2, the shape trigonal planar with the bond angle 120 degrees. Coming to the rules of nomenclature of alkenes, if the parent chain that contain only one double bond, then it is named as alkene, that represents one double bond. If the parent chain is named as alkadiene, nothing but it contain two double bonds. Alkatriene, it contain three double bonds. Similarly, tetraene, pentaene, like that we can write up to now enenes, nothing but poly, alka polyenes, nothing but here there are totally n double bonds in the parent chain. That is the major principle. Coming to the second rule, that is in the main chain the presence of double bond should occupy the minimum position of a carbon atom, nothing but locant of carbon atom should be minimum. Therefore, while selecting the numbering from left side to 1, 2, 3 and 4 will come. Now, while giving the numbering from right side to 1 and 2 as compared to 3 and 4, 1 and 2 are the minimum numbers. Okay, in that 1 and 2, the double bond is present between first carbon and second carbon. Then ene represented with the 1. Then what is the root word here? 1, 2, 3, 4. The root word is but. Double bond between 1 and 2, that is 1. Ene, primary suffix. And hydrocarbon small e. Similarly, while taking another example regarding to the double bond should get the minimum position. Double bond gets minimum position. Carbon atom of minimum position. Then for this one, while giving the numbering from left side to 1, 2, 3. 3 and 4 will come. 3 and 4. And while giving the numbering from right side to 1, 2, 3, 4. Now here also the numbering will be 3 and 4. Okay. If there is an absence of a functional group and substituent, then it depends only upon the multiple bonding. Then either from left side or from right side, both are correct only here. Then what is the root word now? 4, 5, 6. Hex. Double bond between 3 and 4. Nothing but hex-3-ene, and small e represents here hydrocarbon. Now, coming to the third rule, in the parent chain, the selection of parent chain should contain the carbon atoms in large number. Now, even though that contain a less number, the parent chain should contain the double bond. Multiple bonding in the main chain, even though there is less number of carbon atoms. Hence, the main chain is here that contain carbon atoms with the double bond along with the more number of carbon atoms. The numbering will give 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. What is the root word now here? The root word is hex. And now the double bond between 1 and 2 The numbering will give 1 in. There is no functional group and it is represented by hydrocarbon small e. Now coming to the primary prefix, it is open chain, it is absent. Then secondary prefix, 2. At that second carbon, what is the substituent here? 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash. Nothing but the root word is propyl. At that second carbon atom, propyl. 2 propyl hex 1 ene. Right. Now coming to the fourth principle. Now the chain that contains multiple bonding along with the substituent. Nothing but here, the parent chain should contain the multiple bonding and will get the less position of carbon atom. Nothing but priority order of multiple bonding is greater than substituent. Multiple bonding is greater than substituent while numbering of carbon atoms. Therefore, the numbering will give here from right side to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6th one, either beside or top one. 6. Then what is the root word now here? The root word is hex. Hex. And a double bond between 2 and 3. 2 in no functional group, hydrocarbon. And that fifth carbon, it may have the methylene. Five methyl hex 2E. That is the nomenclature. Nothing but the IUPAC name of the given compound in bond line structure. Now while taking the second example, if it contain more than one substituents, the parent chain should contain the double bond along with the less position that contain more number of carbon atoms. Then while giving the numbering 1, 2, 3, at the third carbon atom methylene group will come, the double bond between 3 and 4, 5, 6, 7, 7 root word. Now while giving the right side numbering 1, 2, 3, 4, 4 and 5 will come. As compared to 4 and 5, 3 and 4 is less in carbon position, locate of carbon. Therefore, the root word is hept. Root word is for this one hept. And double bond between 3 and 4. Hept 3-ene. There is no functional group and it is a hydrocarbon. Now coming to secondary prefix, that is near the third carbon atom, it may have methyl. 3-methyl. 3-methyl. Hept 3-ene. 3-methyl hept 3-ene. Now what is the another rule here? If it contains more than one substituent along with the multiple bonding. Therefore, as earlier discussed that there is ignorance of substituents if it contains multiple bonding in the previous rule. Therefore, the numbering will give 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. The root word will come here, oct. What is the root word now here? Oct. And double bond between third carbon atom and fourth carbon atom. Nothing but the numbering will give 3-ene. No secondary suffix. Hence it is a hydrocarbon small e. Now coming to secondary prefix. What is the secondary prefix here? It contains two substituents, bromine, chlorine. As per the alphabetical order, bromine starts with B and chlorine starts with C. Then 2-bromo-6-chloro. 2-bromo-6-chloro. Oct 3-ene. 2-bromo-6-chloro. Oct 3-ene. Right. Then what is the priority order we are giving here? Functional group is greater than, multiple bonding is greater than, substituent. Then but priority order goes to functional group first. It occupies the minimum position of carbon. Now coming to next rule here, in case of closed chain. In case of closed chain along with the substituents, multiple bonding will get the minimum position. Multiple bonding will get 1 and 2 positions. 1 and 2 positions. 1, 2, 3, 4. Either anticlockwise you are giving 1 and 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, both are methylene groups only. That's why either clockwise or anticlockwise, both are correct now here. Then the numbering will give the root word, parent chain that contains 6 carbon atoms, hence the root word is hex. Double bond between 1 and 2, 1-ene. And no function group, hence it is hydrocarbon. Now the secondary prefixes are methyl, 2, 3, 4, 5. 4 comma 5, 4 comma 5 dimethyl, 4 comma 5 dimethyl hex 1-ene. 4 comma 5 dimethyl hex 1-ene. 4 comma 5 regarding to secondary prefix, hex, word root, ene, primary suffix, E, secondary suffix. Now, the parent chain should contain the multiple bonding with the less number of carbon atoms. Therefore, select the main chain here, 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5, 4 and 5, 6, 7, 8 coming, root word. Now here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Give both are correct now here. Both are correct. Then the numbering will give 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. What is the root now, root word now here? Oct. The root word is oct. And what are the secondary prefixes here? It may contain methylene group along with the ethylene. Then alphabetical order goes to E. Then a 3-ethyl, 5-ethyl, 5-ethyl. The root word is oct. Double bond between 4 and 5. Oct 4-ene. Oct 4-ene. Oct 4-ene. That is the higher back name of the given structure. Now in the closed chain, the numbering will give between 1 and 2. Nothing but multiple bond will give the numbering position 1 and 2. 1 and 2. Then clockwise will give. Clockwise. 3, 4, 5, 6. Why we are following the clockwise direction here? Irrespective of anti-clockwise, then the double bond should occupy the minimum position 1 and 2. Here if you are giving 1, 2, here 3 will come. The double bond as well as substituent getting the minimum position. Then what is the root word now here? Hex. Substituents are bromine. 1, 6 numerical prefix di. Substituent bromo. 1, 6 di bromo. Root word is hex. And now here it is cyclic compound. Here also fourth, sixth example here, it is cyclic compound. Hence before that the hex, what will come now here? Cyclo. And that cyclo represents here primary prefix. Cyclo represents here primary prefix. In the same way here also we are getting the cyclo. After that the root word is hex 1-ene. Hex 1-ene or hexene. Hex 1-ene or hexene. Now 1 comma 6 are numbers separated by commas. Hyphen separated by designation. Di represents numerical prefix. Bromo is a secondary prefix. Cyclo is primary prefix. Hex word root. And now here ene primary suffix. Hydrocarbon secondary suffix. While taking the second example here, between 1 and 2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It is also 6 member ring that contain 2 substituents. What are they? One of that is methyl, another one is ethyl. Methyl starts with the M, ethyl starts with the E. Therefore, then by following the alphabetical order, E will come first. 5-ethyl. 1-methyl, 5-ethyl, 1-methyl, cyclo, hex, 1 ena or hexena. Cyclohexa 1 ena or hexena. Same. Here also ethyl and methyl are secondary prefix. Cyclo is a primary prefix. Hexa. What do? And remaining followed by suffixes. Now, while taking one more example, here it may have two substituents, bromine and ethyl. Now, the main chain should contain more number of carbon atoms and the container more side chains. Then the numbering will give 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 4 and 5 are getting from right side to. Now, from left side to 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. 4 and 5. Okay, multiple bonding either from left side or from right side, both are getting same. Then we have to check for the substituent. Substituent bromine will get the first, that is numbering position 2. Now here ethyl will get the position 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Fifth ethyl will come. That's why right to left is correct. Right to left is correct. Hence the numbering of carbon atom 1. 2, 3, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. What is the root word now here? Alt. And what are the secondary prefixes? Bromine, ethyl. Bromine will start first because of alphabetical order. 2 bromo, 4 ethyl. Root word is alt. And a double bond between 4 and 5. That's why 4-ene. 4-ene. 2 bromo, 4 ethyl, opt 4-ene. And one of the problem is here, we have to select the main chain that can have double bond along with the more number of carbon atoms. Then the numbering will give that contain main chain 1, 2. Then numbering 3, 4, 5. Now here 5 carbon atoms come. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. More number of carbon atoms along with the double bond considered as the parent chain. Therefore, the numbering will give from left side to under the parent chain. Hence, the root word is 7. Now, near that second carbon atom, 1 dash, 2 dash, 3 dash. Second carbon atom, propyl. Second carbon atom, propyl. The root word is hepta. Root word is hepta. And now it contains double bond that is between 1 and 2. Hepta 1 in hydrocarbon small e. As earlier discussed that 2 propyl is secondary prefix hepta. Now here cyclo won't come. Cyclo for 8th one. Cyclo for 8th example. And for 6th example, 6th, 8th examples are getting the cyclo and remaining all are open shade. Therefore, secondary prefix, hepta represents word root and small e represents primary suffix, en. Now, small e represents here secondary suffix, that is hydrocarbon. Now, in this session, we have discussed the nomenclature of alkenes with respect to the open chain as well as closure chain along with the importance of functional group, multiple bonding and substituents as per the IUPAC groups. Thanks for watching.